Hey guys, this is Mr. Roxy coming at you from Palm Beach in Florida. It is November the 1st. It is Monday. Welcome to November, everybody. It's going to be a busy week this week, and what I thought to do was not wear my Oxy cap, but rather wear my Mr. Energy cap, and we look at a couple of companies that are scheduled to report this week. So now by the time you actually watch this video, a couple of them may have already reported after the close. Market close on Monday, November the 1st. But anyway, we're going to take a quick look at five of them coming up this week. Two of them, I think, is today. So let's quickly take a look here and sort of dive into this presentation that I put together. And we can talk about this a little bit. So the first thing to do is just maybe revisit the highlights reel for the previous quarter. But before we do that, let's take a look at where we are today. So oil prices have climbed past the key $80 per barrel benchmark for the first time since 2014, and Brent is at its highest level since 2018. There's an OPEC meeting coming up on Thursday, which is probably not good timing because there are companies reporting on Thursday, and we'll have to take a closer look at a couple of those and see what the impact of the OPEC meeting will be. On Thursday, of course, we know that the White House, in its infinite wisdom, asked OPEC to increase production. That is a ridiculous concept when you have energy available onshore, and you can easily ask some of the local producers just to increase their production if you wanted to impact the prices favorably for consumers at the pump. Anyway, analysts don't expect the push by Washington or higher oil prices to result in a flurry of new drilling. Instead, U.S. oil stocks will remain focused on their balance sheet and continued capital discipline. We know this because Vicky Holland, the CEO of Occidental, actually just said so very recently in a communication or an interview that she had with the media. Crude oil. So the reason why I thought I'd put this here is because I don't want us, and maybe when I say us, I particularly mean me, to get ahead of ourselves in terms of where crude is right now. I've on a couple of occasions said with crude in the $80 range, some of these oil companies are just printing money. But it's important for us to maybe set realistic expectations. First thing I want to do is just draw your attention to this little red circle in the middle of the screen here. On August the 13th, which is kind of like smack bang in the middle of the previous quarter, WTI was trading at only $63.69, which is $20 below where it is today. And right here at the bottom of the screen, I actually posted the average prices for the last quarter. And you can see in July, we were kind of sitting pretty at $72.49. In August, we actually dipped $5, $67.73. And it picked up again in September, $71.65. Now in October, of course, we saw a huge increase in the price of WTI, but let's not let the, or allow the current price of WTI for December futures at $83.95 to fool us into a false sense of security where we think we're gonna make more money than what we actually do. Now we have a couple of, interesting ones. And by the way, that little red circle that I drew there around August the 13th is going to be repeated a couple of times as we go through some of these stocks, because I just want to show you the impact of the stock price. The graphs for all of the five ticker symbols I'm going to share with you are year to date. So the graphs are consistent, and the little red circle will show you that dip in August before it spiked to where it is today. Diamondback has been on a pretty good ride for the last year. And as a general rule, I think if you're long on FANG, you should probably be in a pretty happy place. Now, Diamondback is one of the companies that actually reported today after the market closed. So by the time you watch this video, the information I'm sharing with you is not necessarily out of date because these were the analysts' expectations, but certainly you can now cross-reference what Mr. Energy is sharing with you and see where they actually landed. Maybe what I'll do is I'll revisit this again in the next video. But FactSet analysts see earnings soaring 350% to $2.79 per share, and revenue expected to jump 114% to $1.54 billion. Check back after the market closes on Monday, that is today. So Let's see what happened with Diamondback. How about Continental Resources? You can see it wasn't impacted as much in August when crude crashed momentarily. Small little blip for Continental. And if you were invested in Continental Resources, CLR, and you were long, I think you probably have been enjoying your ride year to date as well, as is true for probably almost every energy stock. I know that the energy stocks are not Tesla, but at the end of the day, from a performance point of view, there very frequently is a disconnect between the actual fundamentals of the company, the prices of the commodity, and the stock price. They don't necessarily follow the same trend, but I think it's fair to say if you're an energy investor and you're long, you probably are quite happy with where you're at. Continental Resources estimates swing to a profit of $1.20 per share, up from a loss of 16 cents per share in the year ago quarter. And revenue is expected to climb 103% to $1.41 billion. Check back after the close of market on Monday, which is today. So by now, as you're watching this video, Continental has already reported. So if you're long in Continental, you might want to kind of look back to see how they compare to the analyst expectations. Just to be fair, analyst expectations are exactly that, the expectations. If the analysts have a if the analysts miss badly, you can say they were poor analysts. If the company's performance matches the analyst expectations, it's like, then they'll probably say, we told you so. How about Devon Energy? So Devon Energy also, much like Continental before, just took a slight little blip in August when the share price dropped quite a bit. But once again, you know, at $42 per share, you're probably happy if you long Devon Energy year to date. Devon is expected to report tomorrow. So they are expected to swing to a profit of 93 cents per share versus a loss of 4 cents per share in the year ago quarter. And revenue is seen soaring 200% to $3.23 billion. The reason why I'm sharing these five stocks with you is because they're all reporting this week. The other reason why I'm sharing them with you is because the two that report on Monday, or have reported on Monday by the time you watch this, plus Devon reporting on Tuesday, will give us an indication as to what will happen or what we can realistically or reasonably expect with EOG and Occidental when they report on Thursday. After the market close, I think both of them will check in a minute. Anyway, check back tomorrow after the market closes to see what happened with Devon. How about EOG? So EOG took a couple of dips there in that August period when crude, or specifically WTI, took a bit of a dip. But once again, if you look at the graph here today, you probably are kind of happy if you're long with EOG at $93 and about 50 cents. Not bad. EPS, earnings per share, is seen jumping 370% to $2.02, with revenue up 111% to $4.75 billion. And check back on this one after the close on Thursday, which is the same day that Occidental will be recording, reporting after the market closes this coming Thursday, which is November the 4th. So how about Occidental Petroleum? So currently we're sitting at $34.82. This was sometime today. Well, it says at close 4 p.m. So not too late for the Monday in terms of the price at the close, $34.82, almost 35 bucks. As I've said now four times previously, if you're long Occidental, you're probably okay with where we're at right now, except that Occidental is one of these extraordinary stocks that has been really hammered in terms of the dips and valleys. If you look at the graphs, I mean, we have had some sort of false promises here a couple of times when we went into the 30s, and finally we've kind of sort of settled in the early 30s to mid 30s over the past month or so. Of course, Oxy, as a producer that's producing more than 1 million barrels per day of WTI out of the Permian, is sitting reasonably pretty with the current price of WTI in the $80 range. So Oxy, you know, it's been okay. My expectations are actually higher for the stock price, but as I said at the beginning of the video, sometimes the fundamentals and the commodity price and the stock price are not necessarily tied together, or they just don't match at all, you know. But if you're long Oxy, you're probably okay, right? I mean, if your cost base is $17, you're up 100%, and if your cost base is $11, you know, you're up 200% or more. So it's not bad, but I expect to see great things from Occidental for this quarter. Analysts expect the company to return to a profit of 66 cents per share. Now, a few weeks ago, in fact, in two videos, I was bold enough to stick my neck out and say the analysts are being a little bit conservative, sort of in the first, they had the high 50, so they had about 58 cents per share. And I said, nah, I think it's going to be more likely in the early 60s, maybe even 65 cents per share. Well, the consensus is now 66 cents per share. I don't think that's too high. I think it's probably fair, probably reasonable, versus a loss of 84 cents per share in the year ago quarter. Well, I'm sure we all want to forget the year ago quarter, except for the fact that there was a buying opportunity there when the prices were so low on most of the energy stocks. And they say revenue is seen rising 57% to 6.46 billion. Now on that one, I think the 6.46 billion is a little conservative. And I think my previous prediction of about 7 billion is probably a little bit over optimistic. And the reason why I say that is because when I looked at the average price for WTI per month over the last quarter, for July, August, and September, it was actually slightly lower than what I thought, because we kind of, or I do anyway, get in a mindset of, hey, oil's in the $80 range, so the previous quarter should be good. So I might want to pull my expectation in terms of revenue back a little. I don't know if I can go as low as 6.46 billion. Maybe Oxy beats on revenue and comes close to the 66 cents per share in terms of EPS. Anyway, we only have to wait a couple of days because they're reporting after the market closes on Thursday, and their conference call for Q3 is on Friday. So guys, that's kind of a wrap here. This is five stocks. I'm sure some of them are your favorites. If you're a big time energy investor, you might even have positions in two or three or so of the five. And who knows, some of you might even have all five of those. Anyway, they are good stocks, and they have all been performing really well over the last year to date for sure. And over the last 1 year, absolutely, energy has been a good place for us to park some cash. So let me know in the comments where you're at. I look forward to the conversation as usual. In fact, I just remarked to someone the other day that sometimes the comments on the videos are more valuable than the content shared in my video. Anyway, and if you like the content I create, please subscribe. It helps me a lot and keeps me motivated to keep doing more of the same. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.